last Health Nugget, we looked at what happens in the development of type 2 diabetes, and in today's Health Nugget, we are going to look at who is at risk for developing diabetes, signs to look for that indicate that you might have diabetes, and problems that develop in those who have diabetes. So, who is at risk for developing diabetes? You are more likely to develop diabetes if you are overweight or obese, have high blood pressure, are 45 years old or older, have a family history of diabetes, have abnormal cholesterol levels, have a history of gestational diabetes, like diabetes when you were pregnant, have polycystic ovarian syndrome, if you have heart disease and/or stroke, and if you have depression. And how would you know if you were developing diabetes? Well, there's several signs of diabetes. One of those is increased urination. This happens because the kidneys start dumping the extra sugar in the blood into the urine. And where the sugar goes, water follows. As your blood sugar increases, the sugar in your urine increases, and the water in your urine increases, and you urinate more. Another sign of diabetes is increased thirst. Because you lose more water in the urine, you become dehydrated more quickly, and in response, you become thirsty and start drinking more fluids to replace the water you were losing in your urine. Another sign of diabetes is unintentional weight loss. When insulin resistance increases and the insulin is no longer able to bring sufficient glucose into the cells for their function, they switch to using fat as their energy source, and the body starts breaking down fat to supply the need. This leads to weight loss. This may seem like a good thing, but it isn't a good way to lose weight. Diabetes can have a number of other signs, including blurry vision. You can also develop pins and needles sensation, burning or numbness in your feet and legs, and then in your hands. You can experience increased yeast infections. When you develop diabetes, there are several complications also that you can develop as a result of the diabetes. The most common complication is neuropathy. That's where you have a pins and needles sensation, which progresses to a burning sensation and then later a numbness, typically in the feet and the legs, but can also involve the hands. When the feet are numb, you can injure your feet. You can step on a sharp object, for example, and not even know it. This can lead to infections and amputations. Another complication is vasculopathy. This is disease of the blood vessels that leads to poor circulation. When you have poor circulation, you have decreased ability to heal from injuries, and you can develop ulcers or infections that can rapidly lead to death of toes or feet, and that require amputation. In fact, diabetes is the leading cause of amputations in the developed world. The leading cause of death for diabetes is cardiovascular disease. Diabetes speeds up the process of cardiovascular disease, which includes elevated cholesterol levels, blood vessel inflammation, and cholesterol plaque growth in the arteries, which leads to heart attacks, strokes, and peripheral vascular disease. One study showed that about 80% of diabetics die from cardiovascular disease. Other complications of diabetes includes diabetic retinopathy, which is damage to the blood vessels in the back of the eyes, leading to progressive blindness. This is the leading cause of blindness in the developed world. A kidney injury leading to kidney failure is another complication of diabetes, and in fact, diabetes is the leading cause of kidney failure also. Finally, diabetes predisposes people to develop certain cancers, such as bladder, prostate, pancreatic, breast, colon, rectal cancers. And in our next Health Nugget, we will look at how diabetes is diagnosed and how it's typically treated, so keep an eye out for our next Health Nugget.